you look around and you see a world that cannot be made sense of, you either raise your fists or you say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I was a young reporter for Rolling Stone magazine in 74 doing a piece on Leonard. He's so gracious.
It goes like this, the fourth.
Leonard, he was always a spiritual seeker.
Unlocking the mysteries of life was his primary preoccupation.
Sitting in a meditation hall for 4 or 5 hours a day, you kind of get straight with yourself.
You know, it was often starting with this song. First thing, coffee, then working on Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It was a lot of verses. The number 180 comes to mind.
The real song, where that comes from, no one knows. That is grace. That is a gift. Columbia Records refused to put it out.
The rejection of an album after it's paid for, that's pretty extreme, yeah.
He was crushed after that.
She tied you to a kitchen chair.
The first version of Hallelujah I heard was Jeff Buckley.
Jeff Buckley.
I remember John Cale covering that song. And I remember going, wow, not a lot of people know that tune.
Just Cale and Buckley. And then Shrek. So Shrek really broke it.
And even though it all went wrong.
Hallelujah really beat the odds in that it's its own thing now. And it has its own life.
I mean, I think he was tickled pink that everybody and their sister are singing the song.
Hallelujah.
You're getting things that are so deep and so resonant in your own spiritual journey that you are benefiting from his.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.